Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start with a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is Magnetic Effects of Electric Current. Fine. By now you were learning about the electricity, that it has some effects which are being created when electric current flows through a conductor, and one of them was heating effect of current, and now another effect is magnetic effect of current. So in this chapter we are going to study about magnetic effect of electric current. Fine. So let us start with the chapter, magnetic effect of electric current. Now as the name that has been given, magnetic effect, it means that we are going to deal with the properties of magnet. Okay, okay. So first of all, what is a magnet? This you have learned in your previous classes also, that what is a magnet. A magnet is a substance which attracts small pieces of iron and points in north south direction. Okay, when does it align itself or points itself in north south direction? When it is suspended when suspended freely, or we can say hang freely, then such type of substance is called a magnet. Clear? So a naturally occurring magnet, in your middle classes you have learnt about it, that a naturally occurring magnet is called lodestone. It is an iron ore. It is an iron ore found in the crust of the earth, and it is called lodestone, L-O-D-E-S-T-O-N-E. Fine. Or we can call it magnetite, M-A-G-N-E-T-I-T-E, magnetite. Okay, or it is also a natural magnet. How many names we can call them? Natural magnet. Clear? Now this iron ore, lodestone or magnetite or natural magnet, has a property of attracting iron pieces, and you know it was found in at a place called Magnesia, which is in Greece. Fine. So there is some local story behind this, that how it was discovered, that you have already learnt in your previous classes, like in 6th or 7th class. So we are not going to discuss here. So how does a magnet gets two poles, the names of two poles? A magnet has two poles, and what are the names of two poles? How do we name them? North and South Pole. Okay, North Pole and South Pole. Fine. Now how these poles are said to be North or South Pole? Like this is the earth, and earth has an imaginary line or axis around which it is rotation is taking place, moving. Okay, so this is upper part, this is equator, and upper horizon, the sphere, hemisphere, is called northern hemisphere, and this is called North Pole. We are talking about geographical North Pole, and this is South Pole, geographically South Pole. Okay, so when a magnet is suspended freely, then what happens with the help of a string? Then it is going to keep on moving. It will keep on moving, and after some time it will become stable. Okay, and when it is going to become stable, the direction in which this part, one part of the magnet, is aligning, so it is going to align like this. So geographical north pole, the part of the bar magnet which is directing towards north pole is called north pole, and the one magnet we are talking about which is directing towards the south of the earth is known as south pole. But magnetically this is geographical north pole, this is also geographical south pole, but earth behaves like a magnet also, and magnetically the geographical north pole is called south pole, and magnetically the south pole is called north pole. It is magnetically. Clear? So this is how we differentiate between the poles. So magnet is aligning itself like this. So this is geographical north pole. So we are giving the name as north pole to the magnet. Same is for this another end. This end is said to be south pole, which is directing towards geographical south pole. But if we take earth as a huge magnet, then magnetically this is south pole and this is north pole. Okay, so unlike poles are attracting each other, so this is how we give them the names. The poles are named as north or south. Fine. So natural magnets are irregular in shape. Natural magnets, they are not regular in shape as we have in our, we are using the magnets which are in our daily life used. Okay, and they are irregular. Now the iron objects, they can be converted into weak magnets. And how we can convert them into weak magnets? We can magnetize them. Like if you remember, this is north pole, this is south pole, or let us take this as an iron bar. Iron bar, and we will take one bar magnet. This is north pole, this is south pole, and we will keep on rubbing it. Okay, single stroke method, and this iron bar will convert itself, will get magnetized and will become a weak magnet. So if you recall, sometimes some screws or some bolts are being tightened by the technical people, those who do the technical work. Okay, and they have screwdrivers, and screwdrivers, they become magnetized, and you might have seen that screws, they get suspended on the end of the screwdriver. Actually what is happening, that screwdriver has become magnet. Like if they are doing the work of some speakers or some iron objects, okay, so they magnetize the screwdriver and hold the screws which are not easily can be fitted into the spaces where they are required to be fitted. Okay, so that is a temporary magnet. Fine. So we can magnetize iron bar into a weak magnet by rubbing with the magnet. Okay, so this was about the magnet. Now, magnets are how many types? Magnets are of two types, artificial and natural. Clear? Artificial means they are made by man, by human beings. And natural, they occur in nature. Example is lodestone. Clear? So man-made or artificial magnets are being used by us. So some examples are like Alnico. It is made up of aluminium, nickel, cobalt and iron. Okay, some more are there, but natural is lodestone. Okay, now on the basis of shape, these artificial magnets can be of different types. And what are the different types of artificial magnets? Let us see. They are of bar magnet, bar shaped, north and south. Okay, this is bar magnet. They can be ring shaped, so called ring magnet. Okay, they can be disc shaped, so we call them disc magnets. Fine. They can be cylindrical in shape, so they are known as cylindrical magnet. Cylindrical magnet. Clear? They can be horseshoe shaped, so they are known as horseshoe magnet. So there are various shapes of the magnet that are found. They are also found in the form of artificial magnets, like a needle, which is rhombus in shape. So which is pointing towards, which is actually, this is based on the axis. Okay, and they keep on moving. Fine? Clear? And such type of magnets are known as magnetic needle. Magnetic needle used in magnetic compass, which is aligning itself towards north and south direction. Okay, we have such, so all these are magnetic compass we use it in. So these are different types of magnets that we have already read about in previous classes. Now let us come to the next concept, that why we are studying about all these magnets when the chapter is related to electric current. Why? Because when the current is flowing through a conductor, it attains magnetic properties. Okay, that's why. Fine. So let us quickly learn about what are the properties of a magnet. First property, poles of a magnet. Okay, the ends of a magnet where the magnetic effect is maximum, they are called poles of the magnet. And how many poles are there? North pole and south pole. Fine. Second property is directional property. It tells about the direction. Okay. When a magnet is suspended freely, it comes to rest in north and south direction. So it tells about the direction. So this is directional property. The next is attraction or repulsion. Okay, in magnet, the magnetic poles exert forces on each other. Okay, so if like poles are there, they will repel. If unlike poles, they will attract. So we can say push or pull. Fine. Another important property, that magnetic poles always exist in pair. For example, this is a magnet. It falls down, breaks into two pieces. So earlier, before breaking, it was like north pole, south pole. But when it breaks down and becomes two, then what happens? This is going to have its own two poles, and this part or this piece of magnet is going to have its own two poles. So I hope the things are clear till here. Okay, so this was all about the magnet, properties of a magnet, and some introduction of this chapter. And we are going to discuss further more topics related to magnet and electricity in coming up videos. Fine.